Hi everyone. Today I am going to teach you how to perform 3D clearance analysis as part of the AutoTURN software. AutoTURN has helped engineers around the globe over the past 25 years to perform this task with trusted results throughout the transportation industry. In this drawing, we have a large 3D roundabout with a truck apron in the center. A tractor and trailer is going to be driving through it, and we are going to analyze where the trailer bottoms out. Looking at the terrain pieces of one of the truck aprons, it shows an elevation of roughly 81.9 feet. And if I go to the adjacent road piece, it goes to 81.8 feet roughly. In other words, the truck apron is slightly higher elevation than the rest of the road. So within the AutoTURN ribbon, I am first going to go into settings and ensure that the units are set to meters. That's because the drawing is scaled to meters. And then I'm going to go over to the properties and I'm going to make sure that the conflict analysis is under the right layer. In my case, I'm going to make sure it goes to the layer TS conflict. I'm also going to go to the conflict analysis draw options and ensure all of the colors are set to red whenever there is a conflict. Clicking on the vehicle ribbon, we can see we have the 53-foot lowboy trailer selected as part of the NCHRP659 library. Because this vehicle has a 3D definition, I can view the roofline data. This can be accessed by clicking the View Edit Vehicle Details, and then selecting the Roofline View Data button. While clicking through the parts of the vehicle, we can see at the bottom here the ground clearances for each of the sections. So for this vehicle, it is apparent the tightest ground clearance is at the wheelbase of the trailer. Clicking OK twice then leads us back to the roundabout drawing. The next step is going to be tracing a path in which the tractor and trailer can navigate through the roundabout. In this case, I will switch to a plan view and trace a two-dimensional arc path. Before I generate the path, I will switch the drawing view to wireframe for better visibility. I can now start tracing by clicking the 2D arc path button and then selecting where I want the vehicle to first be placed. I'm going to click once to place it and then click again to set the angle. Now at this stage, I can begin dragging the vehicle and clicking it at various points to make my path. While tracing the vehicle's path, I'm going to have the wheelbase of the trailer hover over the truck apron slightly to intentionally create a ground clearance conflict. Finally, I will left-click to complete the trace path and finalize. Once my two-dimensional path is fully traced, I'm going to convert it into 3D by clicking the Convert 2D to 3D button. So now it has prompted me to select the terrain. In this case, I am going to select one of the road pieces, and now I am going to select the centerline of the two-dimensional path. I am going to select yes to delete the two-dimensional simulation. As a result, we now have the vehicle's path shown in 3D, and it is highlighted in red where the conflict occurs. In this case, the critical conflict was right at the truck apron right here. It is apparent along the trailer's wheelbase, it is bottomed out. For additional detail, I can click Place Vehicle and click anywhere along the trace path to drag the vehicle model. In this case, I'm going to place it where the trailer bottomed out where I mentioned. I'm actually also going to place it where it had this other conflict as well, near the north exit. For even better clarity, I'm going to change the view mode back to realistic so we can get even a better sense of how the conflict happened. Okay, so one final feature I want to show is to view cross-sections and longitudinal sections of the vehicle's conflict. The cross-section can be viewed by drawing a line through the conflict and then clicking Analyze Punch Through. So the first thing I am going to do is draw a line through the conflict. This is going to be my cross-section. Just like that. Next, I am going to click the Punch Through button. And first, select my 3D model. Just going to let it load there. Next, I'm going to click the line which I drew as my cross section. There we go. So it presents me with a label. I'm just going to place it to the right of the drawing. Once I have clicked to place it, it prompts me with some settings that I want to have for the cross section label. In this case, because the conflict happens over a distance, I want to have multiple cross sections shown. So in this case, I'm going to press a checkbox for multiple cross sections. I'm going to set the distance for a total of 12 meters, and the interval is going to be every 3 meters. I'm going to click OK to finalize. It's just going to load now the multiple cross sections. And yeah, we can see all along, the conflict does not happen yet at cross section number 1, but at number 2 it begins to happen. And it just finishes at cross section number 5. I am going to go back to the cross sections at the right of the drawing to see more detail of this conflict. Yeah, so it makes a note at cross section number 3 in red where the conflict has happened. Moving over to cross section 4, it also shows it. But like I mentioned, at cross section number 1, there is no conflict yet apparent. And section 5 also does not show an apparent conflict, although it is super close. Now, as mentioned, we can also see a longitudinal section of the conflict by clicking the vehicle clearance button and then selecting the centerline path. In this case, I'm going to click on the purple line that was done during my two-dimensional trace of the vehicle path. It's just generating. So here I am prompted the settings for the vehicle clearance. So one of the things I can adjust is the positioning of where I want this longitudinal section. Right now it has defaulted to the centerline path. However, because this conflict has occurred on the left-hand side at the truck apron, I want to make it show the swept path analysis to the left. And I'm going to click Place Report to put it just to the right, just underneath where I had the cross sections. And so looking back at the conflict, we can see it occurs at roughly around 40 meters. So moving back to the longitudinal section, I'm going to look around 40 meters, and yeah, we can see in red where the conflict has happened. I'm just going to look at the legend here, and then the bottom of the vehicle is represented in green. So again, we can see in yellow for the terrain and then in green for the vehicle body. That is where they intersect. So that's, again, another confirmation that a conflict has happened. All in all, this tool can be a great way to assess whether vehicles can navigate certain terrain conditions. In this case, had a trailer with a much higher ground clearance been used, this conflict would have never happened. Thank you for watching our how-to video on performing 3D clearance analysis. In this video, we covered a ground clearance check on whether this low-boy trailer can successfully navigate through this roundabout without bottoming out. We hope this video has been helpful and informative and you have learned something new today. If you enjoyed this video, please check out our playlist with more videos on similar topics. These videos go into more depth and provide more insights and detailed analysis on vehicle simulations using AutoTURN. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to stay updated on our latest videos. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments section below. Thank you again for watching, and we'll see you in our next video.